He starred in one of the biggest films of the 80s as a law enforcing machine. Peter Weller made movie history as RoboCop and it earned him millions. But out of his uniform, he's a little more mellow, as Angela Bishop found out when she caught up with the actor in Los Angeles.
We need a 24-hour-a-day police officer.
Drop the gun. You are under arrest.
A cop who doesn't need to eat or sleep.
Your move, creep.
A cop with superior firepower and reflexes to use it.
I'd buy that for a dollar.
He was part man, part machine, and all cop. But there's more to the man behind the mask than meets the eye. Peter Weller first shot to fame in 1987 as cyborg police officer Alex Murphy in the sci-fi mega-franchise RoboCop.
Dead or alive, you are coming with me.
RoboCop was a man of few words. Peter, on the other hand, is not.
So I have a PhD in Italian Renaissance art and intellectual history in ancient Rome, and I teach in Milano or in Palermo.
You do?
Yeah. And I also am a published art historian.
So I've got to call you Dr. Pete.
That's right.
You heard it right. Peter is an expert on Roman and Renaissance art. He splits his time between Los Angeles and Italy, where he owns a beautiful villa.
Tell me about RoboCop. Tell me about what it did to your life. Tell me what it was like to be in the midst of all that.
There's two things about RoboCop. One is it comes out and it throws me in through the whirlpool of shoddy but true success and money. But then there's the process of making it. And the process of making it was quite different from the process of promoting it. So which of which do we speak?
Well, I suppose I was talking about the reaction, which was just so huge, and what change that made to your life.
Well, it started giving me a salary of seven figures, you know, and it's allowed me to live in the places that I want to live in.
Peter likens his experience as a superhero to that of Michael Keaton's with Batman.
And he put down Batman 3, yeah. And I put down RoboCop 3. I'm not trying to sort of resonate this thing, but I put down RoboCop 3 not nearly for the money that he put down Batman 3, but a stack of money. I mean, you and I could go to Vegas for a lifetime on the money they offered me, but I said, no, I got to go do something else. I got to find dignity outside of this thing. And Keaton did the same thing, and now they make a movie about him called Birdman. The similarity of the proximity is not a mistake. No. About a guy trying to reinvent some sense of himself and reclaim some dignity in a business that's also an art form called theater or film, right? And when I saw that, it almost brought me to my knees, because since RoboCop, I think that's what I have always attempted to do.
Yes, I am a cop.
Peter starred in the first two films, but not the third. He does, however, hold a financial stake in the franchise. And despite his conflicted feelings, he's pretty upfront about the financial windfalls the films have given him.
Is it weird being merchandise?
Not when you get the paycheck.
Okay.
Not when you get the profit participation check, it's not.
That's all right.
No, keep buying that crap, man.
Keep buying it. Keep buying your RoboCop toys, kids.
Buy it all.
We're going to put a man inside a machine.
In 2014, RoboCop got an all-star remake.
Dead or alive, you're coming with me.
Did you see the remake?
I did not see the remake, and I didn't want to see the remake, and it wasn't anything like that I was covetous of it or envious of it. I just was done with it. I wished them well. You know, I got a piece of it, so it's not like I wanted to fail or something like that.
What do you think of the proliferation of superhero movies that we see today?
I think that the proliferation of certainly animated heroes that are turned into live action is turning into homogenized crud.
Despite never having been down under, Peter has a couple of Aussie connections.
Now, if you run into Brian Brown...
I often do. What do you want me to say to him?
Peter Weller says, if he was a woman, we'd be lovers.
So who's the man here?
I am.
So you and Brian Brown are close, I gather.
I adore the guy. I met the guy in South Africa doing a movie. He makes me scream in hysterical laughter like a four-year-old girl. And, he makes me go...
His other Aussie mate, our very own Jono.
So what can you tell us about Jonathan Coleman? Is there a dark secret you can uncover that you can reveal now?
I like to say about Jonathan Coleman, other than the darkest secret I know, is that he... quite where that, from what that derives. But I have gone swimming in the Mediterranean with Jono.
He tells us he doesn't wear a swimming costume when he swims. Can you confirm?
I don't want to betray his particular, proclivities to embarrassment. But I have gone swimming in the Mediterranean with him and Margo, his wife, his kids. And I can't confirm that. No, I can't.
Not only is he an actor and a scholar, Peter Weller also considers himself a bit of a Casanova. And he puts it down to one special thing.
How many oysters do you eat a day?
Oh, I can eat 50 at a sitting.
And what effect does it have on you?
It's an aphrodisiac, Angela.
Apparently.
If you're fortunate enough to have, you know, a hot wife, and I got one, you know, the fallout of those oysters is remarkable.
I love it.
Hey, have you thought it all over? Why not make me an offer?
Was made possible all thanks to The Hollywood Show. You forget how well-connected Jono Coleman is.
He's everywhere. In fact, I suspect Jono Coleman will be the next RoboCop.
What a good-looking bloke. Peter Weller.
Peter,
be my RoboCop anytime.
You have the right to remain sexy.